So Jai Hind, we will continue from the previous lecture. Next phase of the compiler is the syntax analysis phase. So syntax analysis phase is also called the parsing, right? So parser uses the token names taken from the stream of tokens to generate the output in form of the tree like structure that is known as the syntax tree or the parse tree. So basically syntax analysis checked if they form a valid sequence of defined inside the grammar of a particular programming language, right? Or you can say syntax analysis is checked if they form a valid sequence as defined by the programming language constructs, right? So parse tree illustrate the grammatical structure of the token of streams, right? The one point noted down here, due to the parse tree arrangement of a stream of tokens, this phase is also called hierarchical analysis, right? For the previous example, the output of the syntax analysis phase will be this one, right? So it will check the grammatically whether the particular stream of tokens form a valid sequence or not. If it form a valid sequence, then you know very well a parse tree get generated. If it will not form a valid sequence, the parse tree never get generated, right? So in this particular string, we will generate a parse tree in this format, right? For id equals to id 2 plus id 3 multiplied by 60, syntax analysis phase firstly perform multiplication as per as the precedence. After that, it will do the addition. After that, it will do the assignment, right? So it will do the addition, after that it will do the multiplication, after that the addition, and after that the assignment, right? So you can see that this tree like structure will be generated as a output of the syntax analysis phase. This tree like structure is called the syntax tree, or you can say parse tree. Next phase of the compiler is the semantic analysis. Basically semantic analysis phase is responsible to check whether a particular statement is syntactically correct or not. Syntactically correct statements are those statements which makes a meaningful reading. For example, a statement in the input program written as x equals to y plus 2, right? Or you can write down float x integer by x equals to y, right? So two different type of data types will be there, right, for the variables. So here I will take x equals to y plus 2 would not make a meaningful reading if we can say x is a name of the function or an array and y is a float type of identifier. This statement might be syntactically acceptable because it can be produced by the help of the context free grammar in the syntax analysis. We can generate the syntax tree for this. But if you will think about meaning of this particular statement, then it is not meaningfully correct because x and y are not compatible type, right? Means is that x and y data types is not compatible. If you want, you can generate the parse tree for this, right? You can generate the parse tree for this. You can write down x, x so parse tree get generated, but meaningfully it is not correct. Syntactically it is correct, but semantically it is not correct. So most of the semantic analysis resolve around the type checking, whether the operator of particular you can say operands of a particular operator are of similar type or not. So besides of type checking, semantic analysis also involves the detection of undeclared variable. Axis violation means class axis correctly or not, and so on. The result of semantic analysis is annotating the parse tree with more information on the data types. So for the previous example, the output of the semantic analysis phase is this one, right? This particular data types here, you can see it is, suppose ID 1, ID 2 and ID 3 are of real type, float type. So whenever you will perform the multiplication over here, right, what happens? This data type is of integer type, this is of real, right, float type. So there is a mismatch between the data types of an operator multiplication. So what compiler will do? Compiler will convert it into the real type. So integer to real will be here, right? After that 60 will be get converted into the real, and after that this operation get performed. Before that it will not get performed. So either compiler itself or the user will do this changes, right? If type compatible T is not there, compiler implicitly do it, otherwise users, it will demanded from the users to do it by displaying the error message. Next phase is the intermediate code generation phase. In intermediate code generation phase, the parser represents the source code into a low level machine like representation, right, that is easy to generate from the source program and easy to convert into the machine language. In intermediate code generation phase, we walk through the annotated parse tree and generate the intermediate code. Basically, there are two types of intermediate code that are common. First one is the three address code, and another one is the postfix code. Another type of representation, graphical representation, is the syntax tree. Syntax tree will also be used as an intermediate code. So most popular out of these three is the three address code, right? So the three address code is a sequence of instruction in which each instruction have at most three operands. Means there is maximum involvement of three memory locations, three addresses, right? Then you can say that is that particular instructions are in three address code, right? So for the previous example, the output of the intermediate code generation phase is this one. What we have to do, we will walk through over the annotated parse tree. You will start from here, right? After that you will go for this one, after that go for this one, right? So whenever you will perform the walk through, what you have to write down, you have to multiply ID 3 and 60 and store it into the temporary, right? So firstly you have to convert it. You have to see 60 is converted into the real, right, and store in temporary. After that you will perform the multiplication and with ID 3 and it store the result into the another temporary. After that you will perform the addition with the temporary and ID 2 and store the result into the another temporary. After that you have to assign this temporary value, this one corresponding to this, into, you can say, ID 1, right? So in step by manner, three address code, in we can write down integer to float conversion and store the result into the T1, right? After that you will perform the multiplication between this T1 and ID 3, right, and store it into the T2. After that we will perform the addition with ID 2 and T2 and store it into the T3, and at last T3 get assigned to ID 1. So this is a results of the intermediate code generation phase. Besides that, there is another parts of the compiler that is called the synthesis of the source program, or you can say back end of the compiler. The synthesis of the source program or the back end of a compiler is responsible for translating the machine independent intermediate code into the target code, where target code may be a machine code or a assembly code. So basically the back end of a compiler depends on the target processor where finally binary would be executed. So back end, or you can say synthesis part of a compiler, consists of the following phases. First one is the code optimization phase, and second one is the code generation phase. In code optimization phase, we have basically optimized the code in term of space as well as in term of time. So how can we optimize the code? We can reduce the size, we can make code shorter and less complex so that it can execute faster and take less space in the memory. Basically, the main intention of the code optimization phase is that the output never gets changed after performing the code optimization. So the output generated by the particular intermediate code generation phase code is also generated by the optimized intermediate code, right? Yeah, you can say code optimized phase generated code. Both will generate the same output, right? So basically, if you will think, this is also called an optional phase. It is not compulsory within compiler. Why? Because the results before and after the code optimization phase will be same. The only difference is that the particular intermediate code will becomes less complex and shorter. We have removed certain dead code, you can say unconditional, yeah, you can say common sub-expression codes, etc. get removed from the particular codes, right? So we have optimized the code. Due to that, the output never gets changed. So if you will use the code that is generated by the intermediate code, or you will use the code that will be generated by the code optimization phase, the working of the both codes are same. Only difference is that the time will become shorter, because code will become shorter, right, and less complex. So due to that, it is called the optional phase. If it is not present, there is no impact on the output of a particular program, right? So you can see from here, for the previous example, code optimization result is same, this one, right? I have take the intermediate code t1 integer to float 60, t2 id3 multiplied by t1 t3 is equals to id2 plus t2 and id1 is equals to t3. So whenever you will perform the optimization, suppose this particular conversion get executed at compile time, so what happens? I will simply write down if it this particular operation will take place at a compile time. So at a compile time, compiler converts the integer value 60 to the float values, right? So this we can eliminate this particular line. Now what happens, you can write down the code for this one, right? Simply writing down this by the 60.0, right? After that, you can see here this t have a no use, right? Firstly, you have assigned value, and this value assigned get to id1. So you will replace this t3 by the id1. So I have replaced this one. So only two lines code get achieved for the you can say after the code optimization phase. Last phase of the compiler is the code generation phase, that translates the intermediate code representation of the source program into the target program. Target program may be a machine code or the assembly language code. If target program is a machine language code, then the code generator produces the target code by assigning registers and memory locations to store the variables defined in the program and to hold the intermediate computations results. The machine code produced by the code generator can be directly executed on the machine. In case of assembly code, mnemonics code is generated, which is translated by the assembler and other utility into the machine language code further. This is a result of the code generation phase. This is the optimized code which we will get from the code optimization phase. After passing this code to the code generation phase, what operation will be performed first? You can see id 3. ID3 is a memory location. ID3 will be moved, right, to the register R2. After that, you will perform the multiplication function with a constant value 60.0. So, for the multiplication, we will use MUL name, right? And it will be the operators of the multiplication 60.0 and R2, because ID3 is moved to R2 by the help of the move function. Now, what we have to do? After performing the computation, we will assign the output to the R2. Similarly, for ID2, ID2 will be moved to the R1, right? After that, perform the addition of R1 and R2, right? And store the result in R1. After that, result of R1, right, is assigned to ID1 by the moving. F is used here, the computation is a floating point type, real type. Due to that, we have write down the F here. Besides of these phases, compiler will contain two more phases are called the symbol table management and error detection and handling. These two phases are connected with the rest of all the phases, right? So we will discuss one by one about the both. Basically, a symbol table management phase is responsible to collect the information about the various constructs like identifiers, or you can say subroutines, or you can say constants that occurs inside the source program. So, in short, a symbol table is a data structure that is used by the compiler to record and collect the information about the source program constructs. For identifier, in addition to its name, it will also contain the information like type, scope, storage space for the identifiers. For the subroutines, it records the number, type of its parameters, the bay of parameters passed, the bay of return type that is used by the subroutines, right? So, symbol table management is an important function of each phase of the compiler. For example, during lexical analysis phase, lexical analyzer identifies tokens and put them into the symbol table. About the type and other information is entered by syntax as well as semantic analysis phase. If you will think about the address, right? So, address is inserted by the code generation phase. Till memory is not allocated, we cannot enter the address into the symbol table, right? So, all the phases will contribute to construct the symbol table. So, symbol table management phase always connected to all other phases, right? Second one is the called the error detection and handling. So, basically, error detection and handling phase deals with the identification of the errors, right? Because the program written by the programmer is not free from errors. There are various types of error occurred inside the program. Out of them, the most popular error are the lexical errors, syntax errors, semantic errors, right? Sometimes intermediate code generation errors will be there, code optimization errors will be there, code generation phase errors will be there. But maximum priority of the errors are from the lexical errors, syntax error and semantic error. Basically, in error detection phase, compiler identify the errors, and to continue the process of the compilation, it will call for the error handler. Error handler takes the appropriate decision regarding that error and makes the compiler to move further to compile the rest of the program. So, this is the responsibility of the error handler to smooth scan of the source program, right, when an error will be there inside the program, right. After collecting all of the errors, error handler display the message for the programmer, or you can say for the users, okay, how many errors are there and where the errors are there, right. So, this is the analysis and synthesis model of the compiler, lexical analyzer, after that syntax analyzer, after that semantic analyzer, after that intermediate code generation, code optimization and code generation. Source program will be inserted as an input here. Stream of tokens will be generated here. Syntax tree will be generated here. Annotated parse tree will be generated here. Intermediate code will be output of the intermediate code generation phase, right? And you can see optimized intermediate code is generated here, and last code generation phase will generate the target program. You will think symbol table management, symbol table is responsible to collect the information about the various construct of the particular programming language, right? So the information, the attributes of that particular construct will be filled by the various phases of the compiler. So due to that, it is connected to all the phases. Error handler will also be connected to all the phases, because error may occur during the any phase, right? If you will think about the type compatibility, so semantic error will be there, right? If you will think about not parse tree will be constructed, means there is something you have written x is equal to by you have write down in C, suppose double z. So what is the meaning of double operator? That cannot be identified by. So there is no parse tree generation. So when you will not generate parse tree, there is an error, right? So such type of error is called the syntax. Whenever syntax is not up to the grammar given for the particular programming language, right? Then syntax error will be there. Lexical error will be there if you will not generate the tokens corresponding to particular lexeme, means particular lexeme will not follow certain rules, then there is a lexical errors. So it is much more about the various analysis and synthesis model, or you can say various phases of the compiler. Thank you.